Good morning children, welcome to today's EVS class. Today's class will continue learning about block 18, air and breathing. So in the previous class, what did we learn children? We learned about the two butterflies. Yes, the two boys, how they kept the one butterfly in a glass jar in which there is the lid is not having holes, and another butterfly which is having the lid with holes, and you all understood that air is needed for breathing, not only for the butterflies. It is essential for all the living things, all the plants, animals and human beings. We need air. What for? For breathing. So what do we call as breathing, children? So whenever we say breathing, we breathe in. Breathing means it has two parts, no children? Breathe in and also breathe out. So we will breathe in, we want oxygen from the air to breathe in. We will give out carbon dioxide. These all you will be learning when you go to the higher classes. But as such, now you should know, we will take in air and also we will give out air. So from the air, we will take in oxygen gas. From the air, we will give out the carbon dioxide which is not needed for our body. So then only the breathing is completed. That's why yesterday when I told you to keep your hand in the chest, you all observed that chest going up and down. Yes, and you all might have learned breathing exercises also. So we are breathing and breathe out. So that is the part of our breathing. So when we are to take in oxygen and we are to give out, so that has to be completed. So coming back to the story, remember that Birju story, one man who came from the village, he came to the city and he started working in a factory. Yes, so what happened, the factory is full of smoke all the time. So as he is breathing the smoke again and again, and he was falling sick. That story, do you remember? That time I told you, I will tell you later about that factory. They mentioned a word called coal, no children? So in that factory, they are burning the coal. That's why the smoke is coming. So coal is a black thing, a black hard thing from the nature we'll get. So that is burnt. They'll burn it and they'll use it. That is used for many things. Even you would have seen the people who are pressing the clothes. Sometimes they'll use this coal in the iron box to not in our houses we use electricity, so they will use it. So it will be a black thing which is used for burning. It's one type of fuel to get the energy. So now this coal burning will give lot of smoke. When you go to some places, you might have seen people cooking with wood, no children? In your home, your mother might be using the LPG gas stove, and or sometime electric oven they'll use. In that there will be no smoke will come. But when we are burning the wood, and burning the plastic or burning the garbage and all, so much of smoke will come. So that smoke, even burning coal, this coal is used for making electricity also. We are getting no electricity. So to burning coal is a part of different factories. So that will produce lot of smoke which will cause the which will make the air dirty. So today's class, first I told two things, that is what do we breathe in? Oxygen, we breathe out carbon dioxide. Even though you don't know the spellings of that, you can understand that breathing, we have breathing in and breathing out. We take in air and also we give out the which is unwanted part of the air. So now today we'll move on to the next part of the lesson, that is the unclean air. So today we'll learn about unclean air. So Birju story, already you all understood that Birju is working in a place where the air is not clean. So unclean air is called as the, it is dirty. Unclean air is dirty, so it is called as the polluted air. Polluted, often you might have heard, no, parents say pollution. So air, polluted air. This polluted air is very, very dangerous for our health. So let us see how the air will become dirty. When you go to your garden, fresh, everything surrounding you is fresh and you feel so fresh and clean air you are getting. But the same air, how it will get dirty, children? How the air will get dirty? Have you seen any time the air is getting dirty? Very good. So we might have seen the vehicles giving out lot of smoke, factories giving out smoke that will make the air dirty. And when you would have seen somebody sweeping, so much dust is coming. Even in your home also, if you dust the sofa or something, you can see the dust particles. Just today, what you do in the dark, you ask your mother or father to give the torch and you just flash the light and you see so many dust particles. You can be able to see from where that dust comes. Dust comes from different things. different things, the dust comes in building, somewhere they are building the houses, that cement, brick, all soil, everything will be giving out some of the dust. Different particles, dust particles will mix with the air and make the air unclean, dirty, that is polluted air. And also, if suppose a person is sick, he is sneezing, he is coughing, he is having some germs in his body, that's why he got sick. So when he is sneezing, coughing, without wearing a mask or without clothing, and that how the germs we spread. Even we learnt in the unclean environment, the garbage lying here and there, that will also make the germs to spread everywhere. So these three things, unclean air. So what are the things which will make the air dirty? Smoke. From where the smoke will come? Smoke comes from vehicles, factories. Different factories will give out, as we told, they will burn different things to manufacture and they will give out the smoke. Dust. Dust will come from buildings, different buildings. When they are sweeping road also, you can better see so much of dust coming, sweeping roads. Different activities like this you can add up. And also the germs. Germs, how it will come? From sick, sneezing, coughing. Who's sneezing and coughing? Sick people. When sick people, when they sneeze or cough, the germs will be spread in the air. So smoke, dust and germs will make the air dirty. And when we are inhaling, see, why are we inside the home? If one person is getting that COVID-19, how it is spreading to other person? By the these germs, by this only, no? He is sneezing or coughing and others are getting. See how dangerous. Same way, dust particles enters your mouth or your eye, how much problem. If you breathe in, then also that will go into your body and it may cause the lungs will become very weak. How much it will be bearing the dust particles? Yes, if you have one book, so many long time you are not using, how much dust will be there? So if you, as such, if you touch it, if you rub your eyes, everywhere the dust will go, mouth it will go, and you are going to fall sick. No children, that's why you have to keep the everything clean. So why? Because this dust is also very dangerous. If it is in the air, it is more dangerous, because we will take the dust along with the air what we are breathing, because we can't live without breathing. And smoke from the vehicles. So vehicles, when they are not using the proper fuel, they make you lot of smoke, and that will be, you might have seen the share autos, so much smoke will come, that is causing the air unclean, making the air unclean. And unclean air will cause many diseases, and they will make the lungs of the different people who are breathing weak, and they may fall sick. See how important is breathing, we understood. And next is breathing clean air is only very important. When you breathe unclean air, it is going to cause us many diseases. See, as I told you, we are taking in oxygen, giving out carbon dioxide. When we are not giving out and we are breathing, for example, you are in a closed room and there is no new air is entering, that is very dangerous. Why? Because after some time, the complete air will be the breath out air only, and it will be having the unwanted gases like carbon dioxide. That is also dangerous. Even when you are sleeping in the night time, if you close the bed sheet completely, full your head, your parents might have told you not to do that. Why, children? Because the breath out air will mix with the inside, you are tightly closed, you know, and again you will breathe that same air and you may fall sick. Because our breathing has two parts, taking in air and also giving out unwanted air. And that air should be clean. If clean air is not, we have to only maintain the clean by making the air. See, plants will clean the air. That's what we are going to learn in the next part of the lesson. So now what all will make the air unclean? Smoke, dust and germs. How they are entering, that also is given here. And why we have to be very careful? Because this unclean air may make us fall sick. So as a part of this, today's activity is in your workbook only. Take open your workbook, page number 11, children. Write the date. Air gets dirty. That's what unclean air I wrote. So look at the pictures below and answer the question. Two pictures are there, children. Picture 1 and picture 2. Cleanly observe the picture. In A question, what is making the air dirty in the picture 1? What is making it dirty, children? Very good. The smoke from the factories and the vehicles. So I am talking about workbook, page 11. Today's date you write, and then there is S2 of block 18 already there. Now first question A, smoke from the vehicle spelling, you have to learn vehicle spelling, and factories. What makes the air dirty? Smoke from the vehicles and the factories. Second question. Picture 2 shows a place where many new buildings are being made. How is this making the air dirty? So, new construction place, the dust from the cement and building materials make air dirty, that is unclean or polluted. So all these spellings you should learn. So second question, why we should not breathe from our mouth? Why you can't open your mouth and breathe? Yeah, see, when you open your mouth and breathe, all these dust particles, everything will enter into your body. At least through the nose it is getting filtered, or nose will somewhat, it will filter and it will send it to the lungs, but mouth cannot filter it. So as such, if you breathe it, you are going to get different diseases and we may fall sick. So now, yeah children, see here the second question, why we should not breathe from our mouth. So when you breathe from our mouth, we will take in the germs, dust, and we may fall sick. It won't be getting filtered. The nose somewhat will filter the air, and the air, whatever the dust particles, not will get filtered, but through the mouth it will directly enter our body without filtering, and it may cause many diseases, we may fall sick. So you can write, germs may enter through mouth and make us sick. Germs may enter through mouth and make us sick. This your parents might be telling, and even this COVID-19 situation, all are saying, don't rub mouth, don't rub the eyes, so that the whenever you touch anything, the germs may enter. And even the when you are opening the mouth while sleeping also, the air, that is also very bad habit. If the air enters through the body, germs or dust particles may enter and it make us sick. So this S2 part you completed. Then see, these are the words today we have learned: vehicles, factories, dust, germs, smoke, unclean, polluted. All these words, keywords, you learn the spelling and you draw in in your EVS notebook or in one paper, you draw unclean surrounding, and what are these, the dust particles, smoke, germs, how they are entering. So in that picture only you can draw how the germs are entering a person. In your textbook you can see, children, very beautifully they have tried to explain you how this is causing. See here in your textbook, page number 113, you can see the smoke coming from vehicles, smoke from the factories, and also see, I told you, some places they will use wood to cook, so that also will cause lot of smoke. And see here how from the muddy road also will have lot of dust particles. Yes, and you can see the child, see, sneezing, coughing, and how is the unclean place, like that one surrounding unclean air, not anything, unclean air, how it is caused. That three things only you can draw: germs coming from something, and the smoke coming from, dust coming from things. Simple one picture you draw as an activity and you can write that. So germs, dust, smoke only should be there. Yes children, from where it comes also just try to write and complete S2 and learn the spellings and be ready for the next class, children. Bye bye children.